हेलो।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
यस सर, गुड मॉर्निंग
सर। यू आर नॉट रेस्पॉन्डिंग।
सर, योर वॉइस इज नॉट ऑडिबल सर फॉर ऑल।
सी, इट वाज ऑडिबल
नाउ
सडनली। व्हाट
इट्स नाउ
हैपेंड?
इट्स
ओके स्टूडेंट्स, आई वाज आस्किंग वन क्वेश्चन। हाउ, टेल मी, व्हाट आर द टू टेक्निक्स दैट वी यूज टू ओवरकम हैशिंग कोलिजन? ओपन हैशिंग एंड क्लोज्ड हैशिंग। सो यू फॉरगॉट, यूज ओपन हैशिंग एंड क्लोज्ड हैशिंग टू ओवरकम द हैशिंग कोलिजन। सो देन वी स्टार्ट विद द टपल कॉन्सेप्ट। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टेल मी, व्हाट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन टपल एंड द लिस्ट? हेलो। Is it audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me the difference between tuple and the list.
Sir, tuple is immutable, list is mutable.
Tuple is immutable, whereas the string list is mutable. Okay, what about the string?
Yes, sir.
What about the string? String is mutable or immutable?
Immutable.
Immutable. Okay, fine. So, students, also yesterday we saw how to create a tuple. So we can create the tuple without using the brackets also like this, but this practice is not much appreciated. So therefore we use this kind of syntax usually to create a tuple. Then, so you should see how we have to create when you have only one element within the tuple. That means you have a tuple wherein the number of elements are one in number, then how to create. See, simply if you create like this, this will be considered as, see here, you are assuming that you are creating a tuple with one element. So, and if you print the x value, it is printing 3, that is fine. But if you check the type of that variable, it will print integer. So therefore, we need to understand when you have a single element, so after entering 3, you have to put one comma so that it will understand that it is an list element. Otherwise, sorry, it is a list element. Otherwise, it will not understand that it is a list or a tuple element. See here, you can put t is equal to 3 comma so that it will understand that 3 is an tuple, the element of tuple t. Now if you check type of t, it will show now this is a tuple. So that is class tuple. Then how to create an empty tuple? This is how you can create an empty tuple. And another way of creating an empty tuple is like this, using the tuple method. T2 is equal to tuple. Then also yesterday we saw how to convert a existing string into an tuple. So T is equal to tuple of name of the string. So hello is the string where each character will become one element when after converting it into tuple. If you look at the string, for string also we do like that only. So while creating a list, so creating a list by using a string, once again the syntax is almost same. Here also each character will be considered as one element. And the difference between this tuple and the list is that the contents of the list are modifiable, whereas the contents of the tuple are not modifiable. So that's the difference. Then how to create tuple using a list? See here, t is equal to tuple of 3 comma. See here, 12 comma 5 is the list. It's a list and these are the elements. So in zeroth index we have 3 and in 1 index we have 2 elements. So 1 comma 0 is 12 and 1 comma 1 is 5. And in the second index we have high. So we are converting it into tuple. So after converting it into the tuple, it looks like this. Then also I told we can also create tuple using another tuple. So for example, you want to create a replica. You want to create a replica just like a copy constructor. So first let us consider one tuple. T is equal to mango 34 and high. So mixed data types we have in the tuple. And we are creating a new tuple out of the existing one. So then we have students, 1 minute, I'll come. Class. Students, I am back. Students, now look at here. So now t is already existing tuple. We have 3 values. So So we have two string values, that is mango and high, and one numeric value 34. And we are creating a replica of the tuple t, that is t1 is equal to tuple of t. So print of t1 means again it will print mango 34 and high. So now if we apply is operator, you know that is an boolean operator. If you check, when you want to check both are similar, okay, if you want to check whether the two objects are similar or not, then we use t is t1. Okay, when you want to check the existence of the element in another object, then we use in operator, and if you want to check for the similarity, we use is operator. So therefore the takeaway from this is that if you want to check for the similarity, you have to use is operator. You have to use is operator. Note that in above example, both t and t1 are objects and are referring to the same memory location, that is t1 is referred to as t. Now consider, elements in the tuple can be extracted using square brackets with the help of indices. So that we know already. Similarly, slicing also can be applied to extract required number of items from tuple. So that means once again the same concept, the concept of slicing already we have used. Okay, nothing new about it. So just like how we can apply the concept of slicing for strings and list, exactly in the same way we can also apply the concept of slicing in case of tuples as well. Now in case, suppose if we try to modify the existing contents of the tuple, that is not a valid thing. Hence it will create an error. That error is called as the type error. Now in the zeroth position already we have mango. So if you want to replace it with kiwi, okay, that is not possible. Yesterday also I have told this. So it will generate an error. If you are making any attempt to change, then it will generate an error. So to overcome that, actually we can use the concatenation operator plus operator to modify the contents. So look at here, we wanted to modify mango by kiwi, which did not work using assignment, but a tuple can be replaced with another tuple involving required modifications. So what are the required modifications? So t is equal to, so you mentioned, so the meaning of this one is you can replace this with a tuple. So this is a tuple with one element. See kiwi, after that comma, then I am closing the bracket. That means I am inserting another tuple with one element. Okay, then, so where I am inserting, that is in the zeroth, in the beginning, that is in the zeroth index, plus, then after that I am concatenating t of 1. So t of 1 means from banana onwards until the end. Okay, from banana until the end means until apple. I am concatenating. Now the end result is print of t is kiwi, banana and apple. So how do I achieve this? So one thing is I have to use concatenation operator, and I have to create a tuple with single element in the first position. So how to create a tuple with single element? So first you create one element, then put comma, then close the bracket. So this is how. So this is very, very important, students. So even this can be in your interview question, because we said the property of the tuple says that actually normally we cannot modify the contents of the tuple, but still we are able to achieve that effect. So by replacing with another tuple. Okay, by replacing it with another tuple, we are able to do that. Okay, this is very important. So okay, remember, so this concept is very important, how to modify the contents of the tuple. Now see how to compare tuples. So this also, see here, when we use double equal to, that is nothing but comparison. Okay, so 1, 2, 3 is not equal to 1, 1, 2, false, and 3, 4 is equal to 3, 4, so that is true. So therefore this equal to, that is Okay, so equal to operator. But when we use less than and greater than, it will not work like lesser than or greater than. So instead, less than is considered as comes before and greater than is considered as comes after. So 1, 2, 3 comes before 1, 2, 5. So you should read this statement as 1, 2, 3 comes before 1, 2, 5. So hence it is true. Similarly, 3, 4 comes before 5, 2. So that is true. Why? Because first it will look at the first element. So 3 comes before 5. So hence it is true. Okay. So then when we have the elements, see here we have one first one numeric and second one string. And here we have first one also string and second one also string. So such comparisons should not be done. So hence it will result in an error, type error. Then students, so then another thing is very importantly, we need to understand how to or when to apply sort method and when not to apply sort method. Can you tell me students when not to apply sort method? When you are dealing with string, lists and tuples, tell me when to apply and when not to apply sort method. Anyone? Hello? Students, anyone, you can answer. Tell me when to put sort, when to use sort method and when not to use sort method. Hello? Students, in case of strings, no problem, you can use sort method. But in case of list and tuples, you make sure that all the elements are of common type, then only you can apply sort element. When you have the elements with mixed data type, you cannot apply sort method. Say, what happens when few elements are of numeric type and few are of string type? Obviously, it cannot deal with it. So that is the situation where you need to avoid sort method. The sort function internally works on similar pattern. It sorts primarily by first element in case of a tie. That means when you have similar elements, then it sorts the second element and the process continues. This pattern is known as DSU. DSU means decorate, sort and undecorate. So let us see the meaning of decorate. So that means decorate a sequence by building a list of tuples with one or more sort keys preceding the elements from the sequence. That means you can sort based upon the elements in the sequence. Then sort the list of tuples using Python built-in sort. So Python built-in sort applies commonly across all sequential data structures like list, tuple, dictionary, then list and so on. Then undecorate means extracting the sorted elements in the same sequence. That is called undecorate. So decorate means making a sequence to see that it is ready for sorting. Then apply sorting, that is sort. First one, decorate means making a sequence, appropriate sequence. Then second step is yes. Yes means sorting. Then U means undecorate, that is DSU. Undecorate means extracting the sorted elements of the sequence. Now consider a program of sorting words in a sentence. So now we have a problem statement where we need to consider a program of sorting words in a sentence from longest to shortest. Say if I give you one sentence, you'll be having so many words. So look at the example here. Now we need to sort in such a way that longest will be the first element and the most shortest word will be the last element. Like that we need to sort. So that's our problem statement. Now first, okay, let us see how to do this. Look at this code snippet. I'll take one variable, words is equal to, and this is the sentence, isn't it? I'll consider it as text, text.split. Students, tell me on what parameter you are splitting here? Hello? Shruti, are you here? Shruti? Lata? Hello? Lata, are you here? Hello.
Best
Tell me on what basis we are splitting the words here.
space after ending the character, we will get a space means we will split, because we
What is the
haven't
delimiter
mentioned
here?
anything in
What is the delimiter to split here?
space.
Space, yes. So that means, say for example, in case if the words are separated by comma, I would have used like this, split of comma. But here the words are separated by blank character. So that means I need not specify anything. So by default, it will understand that I need to split it based upon the delimiter blank character. Then I am creating one empty list, t is equal to list. Then for word in words. Okay, what is words? Words contain a list of all the words. Okay, now I'll put it in the for loop. T dot append of. See what happens when we put two parameters to append. It will enter the len of word. Say for example RAM. So it will append 3 comma RAM. So what? 3 becomes the length and RAM becomes the word. Like that it will append. Then in the second iteration and 3 comma and it will append. Then in the fourth iteration, so in the third iteration we have Sita, 5 comma Sita. So len of word is 5, that is length of Sita is 5 and the word is Sita. So like that it will append. So now it will append, it will create a list T by appending length comma word. Okay, then if you print the list, you can see how it will print. See, it will be printed like this. The list is, you can see, the list is T. So the list is 3 comma RAM, 3 comma and 5 comma Sita. So what is this? The first value indicates the length and the word. Here 3 is the length and is the word. So similarly, 8 is the length and the name is Lakshman. So we have a string, Ram and Sita went to forest with Lakshman. So this is the overall text. Now we are creating a list by splitting it based upon the delimiter blank character. Then we are within the for loop, we are taking one word at a time and we are calculating its length. Then we are creating a separate list and that list looks like this. So that is the list. Okay, then after creating the list, what we are doing? Sort in descending order. Reverse is equal to true. So by default, the sort method will sort in increasing order. Okay, so if you want to sort it in decreasing order, then you have to use reverse is equal to true. As we know that it will sort based upon the first parameter. So what happens when it sorts based upon the first parameter and in decreasing order? Then see, look at this. First element is 8, so Lakshman becomes the first element. Then forest becomes the second element because its first element value is 6. Then Sita becomes the third element, like that. Okay, like that it will sort in decreasing order. Now we are sorting the list t dot sort in decreasing order. For that we are setting the attribute reverse is equal to true. Now here what is reverse? Reverse is the attribute and we are setting its value is equal to true. That means sort in reverse order. Then I'm creating one empty list result. Result is equal to list. So this is an empty list. Then for length, word in t. Okay, so length is a iteration variable. So then word in t. So result dot append of word. So what we are appending? We are appending only the word, not the value. So only the word means like Ram and Sita, those things. Then the sorted list is, you can see Lakshman, So that is because the length is 8 and the forest length is 6, then Sita length is 5, then went 4 with 4. So like that, ultimately the last word is 2. So first we need to understand. So first the first step is to split and create a list. So while creating a list, we have to create with two arguments. So that is length also and a word also. By using the length and the word, we need to append. Then you apply sort method. You know that the sort method, now see here, this becomes one separate list. This becomes one separate list. Okay, like that. And this entire thing is one complete list, and these are all the sublists. Then when you apply sorting in reverse order, so obviously this becomes the first element, Lakshman, because the first value is 8, and the forest becomes the second element because its first element value is 6. So like that, it will sort in reverse order. Then finally, by using the another for loop, we are creating a new list called as a result list. RES means result list, and we are displaying the elements. Okay, and see here, while appending here, we are using only one parameter. We are not using the length. We are using only the word. We are appending only the word. Hence, it displays the sorted list is Lakshman, forest, Sita, went, with, and Ram and two. Okay. So if you give a sentence which contains a number of words, and if we ask you to sort it in order and create a list out of that, so you have to sort the words and create a list out of that. Then you have to do like this. Next concept is tuple assignment. Okay, let us see what is this. What is the meaning of tuple assignment? So that means how to assign values to a tuple. Tuple has a unique feature of having it as left hand side. LHS means left hand side of assignment operator. This allows us to assign values to multiple variables at a time. So when you have normal variables, x comma y is equal to 10 comma 20, that means x is equal to 20 and y is equal to, sorry, x is equal to 10 and y is equal to 20. So x comma y. So x is the first element, y is the second element, is equal to 10 comma 20. So 10, so here, therefore, since x is the first element, after assignment, 10 is the first value. So 10 belongs to x, then this 20 belongs to y. So that's why you can print values for x and y. When you print, x will display 10 and y will display 20. Now, when we have a list of items, they can be extracted and stored into multiple variables as below. I'm creating a list. LS is equal to hello and world, two elements. X comma y is equal to LS. Now you can see. Okay. So x comma y is equal to LS. So actually, why I wrote x comma y, you may be thinking, why I have written x comma y? Because I already know that LS is a list that contains exactly two elements. If I do not know how many elements it contains, then I cannot write this statement. Since I already know it contains two elements, then I can, that's why I have written x comma y is equal to LS. Suppose let us assume now if it contains three elements, okay, hello world and welcome. Then what I should do, if that is the case, then I should write x comma y comma z is equal to ls, because now ls is a list with three elements. Now then I should write print of z, it will print this will print welcome. Here we have three elements. x comma y comma z is called ls. So x is equal to the first word hello, then y will be assigned in the list second element world. Similarly, z will be assigned the last element, that is welcome. So therefore, when I type print of z, it will print welcome. Then this code internally means that x is equal to ls of 0, y is equal to ls of 1, and z is equal to ls of 2. Z is equal to ls of 2. Then the best known example of assignment of tuples is swapping two values as below. So a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20. So a comma b is equal to b comma a. That means this is a swapping. Okay, that means a value will be assigned to b and b value will be assigned to a. So print a comma b, so 20 and 30. That is, first element is 20, second element is 10. You can see that clearly we have swapped. In the above example, the statement a comma b is equal to b comma a is treated as LHS is a set of variables and RHS is a set of expressions. So here, the why I'm telling this example means here we need to understand. So what are the variables and what are the expressions? So now here, if you look at this statement, okay, just observe here the shaded region. Here a comma b, that is the LHS, and b comma a is the RHS. So you should not assume that. See, the Python will not assume both as variables. So Python will assume only the LHS as the variables. So that means here we have two variables, a comma b, and RHS, that is b comma a, that is considered as expression. So b is one expression and a is another expression. It will treat like that, because always the RHS part represents the values. Values are the expression. So that's why in Python, the RHS is considered as expression part, not as the value. Giving more values than variables generate value error. Okay. So for example, if you type a comma b is equal to b comma a comma c, so in the LHS we have two elements, and here in the RHS you should have two only. So in case if you have three, that will give error, that is value error. Like this, a comma b is equal to 10 comma 20 comma 5. So here a will be assigned 10, b will be assigned 20, but you cannot assign 5 to any variable. So therefore this will result in a value error. Okay, you can see that the colored region, that is called value error. In the LHS you have two variables, and in the RHS we have three values. So LHS is not equal to RHS. So hence it is an error. Then while doing assignment of multiple variables, the RHS can be any type of sequence like list, string, or tuple. Following example extracts username and domain name from an email ID. Okay, so let us see how to extract username and the domain name from the email ID. So we need to understand what is username and what is domain name. Say for example, here we have chetanahegde@ieee.org. So this ieee.org is what? Students? Hello? Students, tell me what is domain name and what is username here within the email ID. Anyone? Hello? Anyone can answer? We have an email ID. Tell me what is the domain name and what is the username in that. See, always. See, say for example, 1by18mca13@bmsit.in. So BMSIT is the organization. So therefore, that bmsit.in, that is called as the domain name. That means BMSIT is the organization. IN is the name of the domain. So bmsit.in, that becomes the domain name. and 1 by 18 MCA 13 becomes the username. So like that, similarly here Chetana Hegde becomes the username, then IEEE.org becomes the domain name. So therefore now we need to extract both. So how to extract? Username comma domain is equal to email dot, so email is the name of the variable, dot split of, so split based on the delimiter at. See, it's such an easy thing, isn't it? So now, so we have two variables here. So when we split it, obviously it creates two variables and it creates a list. Then the first value will be assigned to username and the second value will be assigned to domain. So it is such an easy thing. Okay, if you use split method and if you split based upon the delimiter at symbol, it becomes very easy. Then let us see how to deal with dictionaries and tuples. Dictionaries have a method called items. So in one of the class we saw that by using the items method it is possible to print both key value pairs. Okay, otherwise you can print only the values but not the keys. Okay, isn't it? If you want to print both key value pairs, one of the techniques that we use is items method. See here, we have a dictionary D is equal to, we have three key value pairs. First key is A and value is 10. Second key is B, value is 1. And the third key is C, whose value is 22. Now to display both key value pairs, okay, I have a T is equal to, that means here I'm displaying, okay, and at the same time I'm creating a list also. So d.items will just display like this. It will just display like this. Then you want to make it, you want to convert that values into a list, then you put it within the list method. Okay, so d.items by default will display all the key value pairs, that is key colon value comma key colon value, like that. One by one it will display all the key value pairs. Now I want to convert that into a list. Okay, that can be done like this. Print T, so look at here, it is converted. As dictionary may not display the contents in an order, we can use sort method on lists and then print the required order as below. So this is the dictionary. Initially we have a dictionary here, then converting it into list, then T dot sort. So after sorting, you can see it is sorted based upon the key, that is based upon the first element ABC. Okay, so based on the first element it has sorted. Actually we should have converted this into tuples, isn't it? So if you want to convert this into tuple, just I'll write the syntax here. Is equal to tuple of d dot items. See here, the heading is dictionaries and tuples, but we are converting it into a list, isn't it? Which doesn't look nice. So I'll replace this list with tuple, and this I'll make it as list. Yes. Okay. So now the output is same. Okay, when we display the list and tuple, both will look alike. Both will look in the same manner. Multiple assignment with the dictionaries. Let us see how to do multiple assignments with dictionaries. We can combine the method items, tuple assignment, and a for loop to get a pattern from the traversing dictionary. So first let us consider up to here. So we have key value pairs Tom, Jerry and Donald, and you can see the values. Then we have a for key comma value, for key comma value in list of d comma item d dot items, okay, print value comma key. So this syntax, so this is an alternative way. Okay, so how to print key value pairs means we have to use items method. So that is one technique, and another alternative technique is like this. Here the for loop contains two iteration variables, key comma value, in list of d dot items, print of value comma key. Students, will end up here. One minute I'll take the attendance. Tomorrow this module will be completed. Tomorrow we don't have the theory class. Tomorrow we have a lab. Correct, right. Students, answer your attendance. 1 minute and stop sharing.